students, next first year revision program, that second track, first chapter is classification of elements and periodicity in properties. Okay, so coming to classification of elements, you know that periodic table at present contains totally 118 elements. So totally 118 elements are there. Out of 118 elements, elements after atomic number 92, all are considered as synthetic elements after atomic number 92. They are synthetic elements. Synthetic elements means artificial elements, man-made elements. Okay, and elements below this atomic number, they are naturally occurring elements. Okay, and these are synthetic elements, purely artificial elements, and most of these elements are radioactive in nature. Okay, radioactive elements. So to know the property of each and every element individually, it is quite impossible. So that's why elements which shows the similar properties, they grouped together and they divided into different classes. Okay, so many types of classifications are made by scientists. Okay, and very first classification of elements, so that is done by Dobereiner. Okay, so first classification, Dobereiner classification, and Dobereiner arranged a set of three elements in the increasing order of their atomic weight. He took basis for the classification is atomic weight. Okay, so basing upon the increasing atomic weight of the elements, he arranged three elements. Okay, so a set of three elements, that is called as triad. Okay, so coming to Dobereiner triads, so each triad having three elements. Okay, then all these elements are arranged in the increasing order of the atomic weight. Okay, atomic weight is basis for this. So lithium, sodium, potassium, this is one triad. Okay, chlorine, bromine, iodine, another triad. Okay, calcium, strontium, barium, this is also another triad. So these are triads which are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic weight. And here atomic weight of the middle element is the average of first and last element. Okay, so this is the very first classification, so which is made by Dobereiner in the form of triad. Next, telluric screw classification. Telluric screw. This classification that is made by D. John Curtius. Okay, so scientist name D. John Curtius. He made the classification of element. He arranged the elements in the increasing order of their atomic weight, and he framed a helical type of periodic table. He arranged elements in the form of a helix like this. Okay, helical type. Okay, which is cylindrical, cylindrical form of the periodic table. Okay, so here also basis for the classification is atomic weight only. Next one is Newland's octaves. Here also, Newlands, scientist. He arranged the elements in the increasing order of their atomic weights. Okay, according to increasing order of their atomic weight. And here, one important thing is, properties of every eighth element is similar with first element. Okay, just like in musical notes, every eighth note is similar to first note. So, that's why these elements are also called as octaves, Newlands octaves. Okay, so here also atomic weight is the basis. Next, coming to Lothermeyer classification. Lothermeyer classification. So, in Lothermeyer classification, he considered atomic volume is the basis for classification, and he arranged all the elements according to the increasing order of the atomic volume. Okay? So, you know that density is equal to mass by volume. Okay? So, here atomic volume is considered. Volume is equal to mass by density. So, basing upon that, he framed a new periodic table. So, that is Lothermeyer's classification. Okay? Atomic volume is basis for that. And next, coming to Mendeleev's periodic table. Mendeleev's periodic table. So, in Mendeleev's periodic table, basis is atomic weight only. He also arranged all the elements in the increasing order of the atomic weight. And also, he proposed a periodic law. Okay? So, according to Mendeleev's periodic law, physical and chemical properties of all elements are periodic functions of their atomic weights. Okay? He proposed a Mendeleev's periodic law. So, Mendeleev's periodic law. So, according to this, physical and chemical properties of all elements are periodic functions of their atomic weights. So, this is Mendeleev's periodic law. Then come to Mendeleev's periodic table. So, Mendeleev's periodic table. This is also called as short form of periodic table. Okay. Short form of periodic table. And Mendeleev's periodic table contains totally 63 elements. Okay, so 63 elements are there, and all these 63 elements, they are arranged in 7 horizontal rows and 9 vertical columns. Okay, so Mendeleev's periodic table contains 7 horizontal rows. Horizontal rows are nothing but periods. So, it contains 7 periods and 9 groups. Okay, 7 periods and 9 groups are there. So, total all these elements are arranged in 7 periods and 9 groups. But at first, 0 group elements are not included in Mendeleev's periodic table. Why? Because 0 group elements are discovered in the 19th century. Okay, so that's why after framing all Mendeleev's periodic table, and at the end, zero group elements are linked to Mendeleev's periodic table. Okay, then importance of Mendeleev's periodic table. So, what is the basis for the periodic table here? So, atomic weight. So atomic weight is the basis for periodic table. So all the elements are arranged in the increasing order of their atomic weight.